it said that you all would tailor make songs for the different artists. So like you would tailor make a song for Lou Rawls, for Teddy Pendergrass, Patti LaBelle. How did you know, like, say a song like You'll Never Find would be the perfect fit for Lou Rawls?
Huff would, we'd be in there with, on the piano, he would find the key. And the key that we thought that they would sing it in. And I think that helped out a whole lot. So it's the science of the whole thing.
Those one or two different keys can make all the difference in the world. You rarely ever find a producer and a songwriter, a producer that can't sing. Gamble can sing, and Huff can sing, and I can sing. So we can, even if we don't sound good to anybody else, we sound good to ourselves. So in our minds, we sound like the artist, so we can imitate the artist. If we can't imitate you, it's going to be kind of hard for us to write for you. Just like a suit is tailor-made with the correct amount of the length. Waist has to be 38 or whatever it is. All those are measured. We do the same thing.
One song that has been widely covered and sampled by so many people is the song For the Love of Money that talks about greed and materialism. Can you tell us a little bit about how the song came to be?
The Bible said the love of money is the root of all evil. You know, it didn't say money was evil, because you need money, but the love of money is what we were trying to penetrate with that record. Some of the lyrics was that a woman will sell her body for the love of money. For a small piece of paper, it carries a lot of weight.
When you were writing these songs, like If You Don't Know Me By Now or Me and Mrs. Jones, are those songs, were they created by experiences that happened within your life?
You know, we wrote songs about our life, living life, and trying to make music and raise families. And it was tough. If you don't know me by now, you never know me. I loved the way I played it. I felt it when we were writing it.
How did you know? Like, what was the feeling that you got?
It was a feeling. It's always a feeling with me. Yeah, well, you know the story.
Mm-hmm.
We got that piano from Cunningham. And the piano, the action wasn't fast enough for me, because the piano that I was raised up on in Camden, and my mother played piano beautifully, and that piano had a fast bass. So something told me to take the top off, take the whole top off. And I went to the drugstore and I got thumbtacks. And I got the thumbtacks and I put them behind each hammer, 88 of them. And when those thumbtacks popped off them keys, it was a whole different method. Me and Gamble didn't write on a normal piano. Mm-hmm. And when Gamble heard them sounds come out that piano, it was like listening to a synthesizer. And I used the loud pedal as a percussion, so I had to have that backbeat. And I could write songs like Love Train, up-tempo songs like For the Love of Money with the bass lines. I love music with the bass lines. Those bass lines was coming out that piano like thunder. And Gamble was riding the waves of them rhythms like I've never seen before.
The bass is exactly what it is. It's the basics. The basis of everything. If you want to build a one-story house, you want to build a thousand-story house, you got to have the basics, the bass.
Let's talk about Cry Together and Only the Strong Survive. So it talks about heartache. You know, is this firsthand experience, say, Mr. Huff, is this a firsthand experience that you may have had?
Only the Strong Survive, we collaborated with Jerry Butler, right, guys?
Mm-hmm. Right, yeah, that was a great experience. Because he knew how to pull the story together from out of his stomach.
Yeah.
You know, he was amazing, you know.
He was spontaneous, and, too.
I done had a couple heartbroken. And have given a couple heartbrokens. And the older you get, the wiser you get, you know, and you cherish things more.
Hey Gamble, we wrote a song called I Was Married.
Married, yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's true. But, and you know, Everything. I was married and it just didn't work out right.
Hey, Gamble, how about 992 arguments?
I was just about to ask about that song. Is that something that y'all experienced?
That's right.
And me and Huff was over in Camden. We was writing songs that day. And we went out to get a beer. And when we came back in, there was somebody there said, well, where y'all been at? What y'all doing? Or whatever, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Man, listen. That's how that 992 argument started. And once we got in the studio with it, I never heard that band play better.
Let's talk about Cowboys to Girls. In this coming of age song, what was the songwriting process in terms of thinking about it from like a child's perspective and then bringing it to like an adolescent's perspective?
Cowboys to Girls, that song just came out, and Gamble wrote a great lyric. I felt it was different. Loved the
it
way
was different.
Sang it.
It was different.
You know, and the story was unique, and was just a clever, clever record.
What that song was saying, that you get to a certain age, and you went from cowboys, playing cowboys, to running after these girls. And so, you know, I remember when I used to play Shoot 'Em Up, Bang Bang.